What's your impression here as we get to the final match of this season about the strides you've made on your team?
Right, I think we've definitely shown a lot of improvement from last year. Last year, like we said several times, was kind of a transition year for us. We were always a top competitor in the NAIA, and that was something that we really wanted to carry over when we transitioned to D2. And we weren't, we were pretty unsure about what the differences were going to be like, how similar the competition was going to be. But I'm really proud to have seen, especially through my 4 years, because I've been right in the middle of that transition. I'm really proud of the group of guys that we've gotten to where we dealt very well with that transition, and we stepped up our game whenever it came time to move into the D2 conference, and we really haven't let it drop our level of play or hurt us at all. And like I said, we've improved a lot since last year. This season, we were at number one in the conference at one point, and we've had some tough results as of late. But as of right now, we're qualified for the conference tournament, which we didn't do last year. So that was one goal that we've achieved this year that we didn't last year. So as of right now, we're just looking forward to this game against Rockers, finish off a good season, and then see what we can do in the conference tournament.
Do you guys have a sense of, I guess, history that, boy, you were NAIA, now you're Division II, and you were the class kind of that was in the middle of that?
Right. I mean, I think it was definitely an interesting time for the program, something that not a lot of classes will be able to say that they got to do, to play 2 years in NAIA and then 2 years following in Division II. So it does feel great. I mean, it really didn't seem like too tough of a transition for us, honestly. And a lot of that helped with our addition of redshirt guys, the transfer students last year with Matt McDevitt, Sam Braverman, and Zane Christensen. They stepped in and played some big roles for our team this year to add to, the steady back line that we've had with Chad Newman and Ryan Squires and Cole Prather and even Pete. We know that Pete Neckbottle switched between center mid and with me and back and center back. So we always had the back line, the defense to do it, but our probably going to D2, our biggest concern was where we're going to be able to put the ball in the back of the net. And so, like I said, the addition of those transfer students really helped us to step our level of play up, and we really added that finishing touch up top to get some goals on board. So that helped a lot this year.
Okay, you've talked about the forwards, you've talked about the defenders in the back row there, the back line. What about your role? Explain, if you would, your role in the midfield area.
Well, I've throughout my 4 years here, I've been lucky enough to have held down that center mid role. I haven't had to worry about changing positions a lot. Coach Robley has had a lot of faith in me in the middle since I was a freshman here. So it's gotten to the point where after this 4 year buildup, I've gotten very comfortable in there. But as for my role, I have never in my 4 years, I haven't really been a big stat guy. I haven't put a whole ton of goals on the board or a whole ton of assists. But I like to think of myself as kind of an engine in the middle, just kind of the workhorse that, I have to play. Being a center mid, you're playing both sides of the ball constantly. A lot of it is a transition game. You have to transition from defense to offense very quickly. And one thing I always focused on with my game personally was just to make sure that we maintain possession with our team. That was always one of my biggest focuses, and I like to make sure that our team keeps the ball and do whatever I can to win the ball back when we lose it and make sure that we keep it when we have it and to be able to start the attack. So a lot of it is just work rate in the middle. That's, I think, where I do best is when I'm forced to just put 100% effort in and work. And, I may not be the most skilled player on the ball, but I think that, I make up for that with my work rate and just the transition game between offense and defense and back and forth. So.
Was that the kind of thing that got you noticed coming out of high school, just that work ethic?
I think so. Definitely, especially coming in freshman year. I was up against guys like Manny Tovar and Justin Beck, who Justin Beck went on to be an All-American. Manny Tovar was a great center mid. So, it was a very humbling experience for me. I didn't really expect to get a whole lot of playing time coming in. I just kind of had one goal or one idea behind it, and that was to come in and you're going to work as hard as you possibly can and just see what you can get from there. That's all you can really ask of yourself, and you don't expect a whole lot of playing time coming in as a freshman. And I think that my work rate is kind of what got me in the position to where I got some good playing time freshman year with Manny and also alongside Justin Beck as well. So,
senior night was last week. How did you feel about that? What were your emotions that night?
Senior night was great. You know, it's always a humbling experience to have senior night. You know, you always hear that phrase, that'll never be me. You know, you hear from seniors every year that time flies. You know, it's, you know, enjoy it while you can because it'll be here before you know it. And every year I'm just like, yeah, right, you know. It feels like I've been here forever. And then all of a sudden you wake up from the dream and senior night's here and you're standing out there with your fellow seniors and they're announcing you. And it was a cool experience to go out and give the fans a good performance that night. It was a really, really important game for me and for our fellow seniors. Just kind of a culmination of our efforts towards the program after 4 years. And it was really great, obviously, individually to get a goal in that game as well. But just overall, as a team, to get that win was great on senior night.
Is Rockhurst our big rival in soccer? Is that who you'd put number one?
I think so, yeah. I think Drury could also be close with the last 2 years, how both games have gone. I mean, both games in the last 2 years have been last-minute overtime goals. So any time that you have games go like that, it just a natural rivalry usually builds up out of that. But I think there's a lot of respect between the two teams with us and Drury, and the same way with Rockhurst.
Last year, speaking of Drury, early in the season, we played Drury, first GLVC game. It goes one overtime, goes two overtimes, and then we get this guy step up and hit the penalty shot that wins it.
Right.
I don't know if it was your prettiest shot ever. It was certainly one of the best I've ever seen. How memorable is that goal? Let's start with that.
Oh, it's definitely probably one of my best soccer memories that I've ever had. Just because of what that year meant. It was our first year, like we said, into Division II. I think that being our first GLVC game ever and getting that goal with, you know, 3 seconds left, definitely one of my favorite memories, something I'll never forget.
You hit the goal and you realize it's over. Where did you go? Because I lost track of where you were in that mess of people on the field.
To be honest, I think I kind of blacked out a little bit. I mean,
I
remember is just as soon as I saw about mid-flight of the ball that it was going in, and I just took off running. It was just natural instinct. I didn't even have control of my body at that point, really. I kind of just took off running, wanted to find my teammates, wanted to, you know, be with them and also run to the fans and give them some thanks for coming out and supporting our team. So really at that point, it's just kind of all adrenaline rush. There's not a whole lot of control I had or that you typically have. So I kind of just took off running the rest. Just happened.
Well, just like senior night, graduation day is not all that far away for you. And what happens after graduation for you?
After graduation, I will be applying to physical therapy school. I'll probably be looking at some schools close here or nearby here in the Kansas City area, like Rockhurst and KU Med. Ironically, Rockhurst is one of my top schools that I'm looking at. They have a great physical therapy program. After that, I'll start that application process pretty soon after graduation and then just kind of wait on the results of that, go through all that whole process, and hopefully we'll have another 3 years of school in a physical therapy program. And after that, it's have my degree in physical therapy and then hopefully just kind of work my way up in that industry. And my long-term goal would be to hopefully open my own practice that kind of focuses on athletes and their rehabilitation with injuries and stuff like that.